Hello everybody, my name is Sviatoslav and today we will talk about what is eyes fatigue syndrome or astenopia, what is dry eyes syndrome and computer vision syndrome, how it all appears and how to avoid it. What is eyes fatigue syndrome or astenopia? This is the condition when during visual work the eyes get tired fast. This happens more often when the observed object is at very small a distance from the eye. There is muscular astenopia and accommodative astenopia. It most often occurs with people who read a lot or work on a computer incorrectly without taking off their eyes off the screen and forgetting to switch their gaze to distant objects and without blinking. Astigmatism, myopia and hyperopia can also contribute to it, or after a long time, defocusing may develop when observing nearby items. Muscular astenopia most often develops with untreated myopia. Sometimes it is caused by a congenital weakening of the internal rectus eye muscles. Because of this, the occurrence of a violation of vision and the development of a squint. Accommodative astenopia develops due to excessive fatigue of the ciliary muscle of the eye, which regulates the curvature of the lens, as well as for astigmatism or hyperopia. Symptoms: a feeling of heaviness and fatigue in eyes after prolonged visual work at a short distance. There is headaches and eyes pain. The size and shapes of the observed objects is distorted. Lacrimation: the diagnosis is made after an eye examination by an ophthalmologist and examination of the patient's complaints, often simultaneously detected astigmatism, weakness of the ciliary muscle, myopia or hyperopia. For the treatment of this condition, general strengthening therapy, correction myopia or hyperopia, if any. Try to determine the balance of time for work and rest for eyes. For example, when working at a computer, it is necessary every hour for 10 minutes to interrupt and look from the monitor to the window, focusing alternately on a distance, then to near objects outside of the window. Dry eyes syndrome. Dry eyes syndrome appears because of the lack of hydration of the conjunctiva under certain conditions. The surface of the cornea and conjunctiva can dry out, most often due to rare blinking. Dry eye syndrome occurs in 9-18% of the population and occurs more often. Over the past 30 years, the incidence of dry eye syndrome has increased by 4.5 times. Of course, the popularization of smartphones greatly affects this condition, but also laser vision correction can have the same effect. Contribution to the dry eye syndrome makes systematic use of medicine of various type. Great use of cosmetics and cosmetic operation. Common diseases can also be accompanied by dry eye syndrome. With this syndrome, a person feels a dryness in the eyes and also notices that his bed carries wind, conditioned air, smoke, etc. Examination by an ophthalmologist reveals a decrease or absence of lacrimal menisci at the edges of the eyelids. Also, a person may have feelings of foreign body in the eyes, a burning sensation and cramps, deterioration of vision in the evening, photophobia, lacrimation, pain when using eye drops. The diagnosis is based on the patient's story and examination with a slide lamp. It is important to establish the cause of this condition. Treatment is aimed firstly at replenishing the lack of tear fluid, secondly to reverse the development of corneal changes. Now to fill the lack of tear fluid, medicine such as artificial tears in the form of eye drops and gels. There are a lot of these drugs and they have different properties, so they can be used for different variations of dry eyes syndrome. Also, great importance is the individual sensitivity of a person to this medicine. Someone tolerates them normally, but for someone it doesn't fit and cause inconvenience. If the syndrome arose as a complication of any eye disease, then of course they're treated this as a disease. But the most important and useful natural exercise is to train yourself to blink frequently and correctly with relaxed eyelids. Computer vision syndrome. This name appeared in 1998 and was introduced into circulation by the American Association of Optometrists. So they called the complex of visual and eye symptoms caused by work on the computer. And this happens because about 60% of computer users complain about their eyesight. 22% of those working at the computer also there are accompanying complaints of discomfort, pain in the neck, back and shoulders. The reason for the development of computer visual syndrome is a difference of images on the monitor and on paper. The picture on the monitor is self-luminous and not reflected discrete, consisting of pixels, and the human visual system is adapted to perceive objects in reflected light. The following factors contribute to the development of this syndrome: incorrect position of the user in relation to the monitor, incorrect position of the monitor in relation to external sources, lighting, glare on the screen, excessive or insufficient illumination of the room, incorrect settings of colors and light transmission of the monitor, inconsistency of the technical parameters of the monitor required for long-term safe work, incorrect working with a computer, the need to transfer the gaze from the screen to keyboard, text on paper, walls, windows or some other distant objects, insufficient hydration of the cornea due to increased tear evaporation during a decrease in blinking movements of the eyelids. A healthy person makes an average of 18 blinking movements per minute. Research has shown that computer users have the frequency is reduced to 4 per minute. Computer vision syndrome is manifested by the following symptoms: decreased visual acuity and blurred vision, difficulties in transferring gaze from near object to distant ones and vice versa, apparent change in the color of objects, double vision of objects, goose bumps and darkening in the eyes, increased photosensitivity, eye fatigue. In addition, there are pain in the eyes socket and forehead, pain when moving the eyes, redness of the eyeballs, feeling of sand under the eyelids, lacrimation, pain in the eyes, dryness and burning in the eyes. Treatment of computer vision syndrome consists in changing the factors listed above as its reason. This means that you need to properly equip the workplace. Indoor lighting should be uniform and sufficient, while bright light sources should not be in the field of view of a person. It is necessary that the computer screen doesn't glare. The monitor should be located not more than 10 to 25 centimeters or 4 to 10 inches below the horizontal line of eyesight. At the optimal working distance to the monitor is 50 to 80 centimeters or 20 to 30 inches. It is advisable not to work at the computer more than 1 hour without interruption and not more than 6 hours in total. If this is unrealistic, then the 20-20-20 rule should be applied. Every 20 minutes, break away for 20 seconds and watch forward 20 feet or 6 meters. It is also advisable to take 5 minutes break and close your eyes for at least 10 seconds after every hour of work. Now, factories began to produce special computer glasses with light filters, which optimize the spectral composition of visible light. Moreover, a doctor can use such glasses prescribed for people with visual impairments, myopia, hyperopia, etc. Wearing contact lenses while using the monitor increases corneal dryness. The onset of symptoms of computer vision syndrome is mainly associated with a lack of tear fluid caused by its increased evaporation. Usually, symptoms of computer syndrome completely disappear after stopping work at a computer, and they resume when the person starts looking at the monitor again. Thanks for watching this video to the end. Today we learn about eyes fatigue syndrome or astenopia, dry eyes syndrome, computer vision syndrome, how it appears and how to avoid it, correct and frequent blinking, as well as providing regular rest for your eyes, as well as changing the distance to the objects you're looking at, can greatly help you to avoid these diseases and keep your vision in excellent condition. Subscribe to my channel for more great benefits, and we'll see you again.